Hey everyone, it's Brian, the host of this little English 102 Big Idea Show. Today we're going to talk about Chapter 5, so without further ado, let's get started. Okay, here we are talking about plot. There's some stuff in the book about this and also some stuff in Blackboard that you can read about. By the way, I'm wearing a hat today, total bad hair day, so I'm like, I better put a hat on. Chapter 5 in Blackboard, there's some stuff that describes plot and a few terms, but there's not a lot there about how these things fit together. And so I wanted to put together a little diagram for y'all that kind of shows how this works. So very often what the internet tells us is this is something called like a plot mountain or something like that. I like to call it sort of like the order of events, more or less, of how a story goes, but this is kind of how it happens. So more or less, you start down here, and this just has to do, look at me, looking at the notes, this has to do with the exposition of the story, and that's just really the background stuff about how things are going to go. Now this next part has to do with what we call the rising action, and this is where stuff happens, right? So over here we've got the conflict, and that was a big part of what the chapter was about, this whole business related to conflict. And then as we move toward the climax of the story, there might be some foreshadowing going on and other details that sort of lend information about the story. And then as the climax happens, maybe we're over here and we've got some epiphany happening where I remember the character basically makes some discovery and their mind is kind of blown, more or less. Where are we going from here? Oh, and then over on this side, we've got the falling action, more or less, and then which leads us to the resolution. But I think this is really the business end of the story, moving from the very start where there's exposition, details, the conflicts get developed, there might be foreshadowing, and then that epiphany happens as well. So there's a lot happening on this side, and that's really the meat and potatoes of how plot works, more or less. So when you think about these terms that just got introduced, think about how they're gonna work in context with everything on this particular pyramid. It's a pyramid. What did I call it before? I totally forget. But that's my big idea video for today. I'm hatless now. I appreciate your time today. There was something flying around out there, like a stink bug or something. I appreciate you dropping by for this big idea video, and we'll see you in the next one. Peace.